Hey everyone, how are you all? My name is Pratyush and you're watching Just Robotics India. So in this video, we're going to look at the very basics of Fusion 360. So first we're going to learn how to draw a two-dimensional sketch in Fusion and then how to convert that into a three-dimensional model. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
Let's go ahead and open Fusion 360. In this video, we're going to make a three-dimensional cube from a two-dimensional square. Now in the workspace, towards the left hand side we have our browser which contains all the information of activity. On the right hand side we have our view cube and at the bottom we have our timeline. At the top we have our tools. So here there are many ways how we can draw a three-dimensional cube. So we'll be looking at some of it. Now at the top left corner we can see design. So you have to be in the design workspace for drawing. So now let's create sketch. So click on create sketch. So you can see there are three different planes that are formed. Now these three different planes are correspondence with the view cube. So you can, you know, move it around by rotating the view cube. So in order to draw, you have to select a plane and click on it. So let's select a plane. So once you are in a plane, now you can start drawing. So here to make a square, I'm going to use a line tool. There are other ways how you can do it. We'll be discussing it further in the video. So let's go and click on create and click on line. The shortcut for line is L. So let's click on line. Now click on a point and drag it. So you can see we can enter the value. So here for the example, let's enter the value as 50. Click enter. Again, go to create. Click on the line. So draw a vertical line. Again, enter the value as 50. Now we have to repeat this. Again, select the line. Continue the line. And click in the point from where we started. Now we have a close figure which is indicated by the orange color. So let's go ahead and click on finish sketch at the right hand side. So once you press finish sketch, now you can see we can move it around. Now if you press shift and the middle mouse button, you can move around your object. So now let's make it into three dimensional. So go to create and click on extrude. The shortcut for extrude is E. So here we have to select the profile. So let's go ahead and select this as a profile. So you can extrude in many different ways. Like you can extrude it in one side, like how we have it here. So if you pull the blue arrow, you can see that we can extrude it in one direction. Now instead we can go and make it into two sides. So in two sides you can extrude the same object in both the directions, as you can see here. And then there is symmetric. In symmetric, once we select the plane, you can extrude it symmetrically in both the directions. However, for this example, let's do it in one side. So click on one side. Let's enter the value as 50 since it's a cube and press OK. And hence we have created a cube successfully with the help of line tool and extrusion. Now let's go ahead and draw a cube with the help of the rectangle tool. Click on rectangle. We can have 2-point rectangle, 3-point rectangle and center point rectangle. Let's click on 2-point rectangle. So once you click on 2-point rectangle, now we have to select 2 points and the rectangle will be formed in between. So let's go ahead and click a point somewhere. Okay. So now when we select a next point, you can see that the rectangle is formed between these 2 points. So again, go and click on 2-point rectangle. So let's make a cube. So first we have to draw a square. So type in 50, press tab, and again type in 50. So now we have a square of 50 dimension. So the second way how you can do this is with a 3-point rectangle. So here now we can draw a rectangle with 3 points. So we click on one point, type in 50, and click on the next point, and finally choose a third point. Again, you can enter the value as 50. So now a square is formed with 3 points. You can go back. There is one more way how you can do it with a center point rectangle. Now here you have to select the center point of the rectangle. So let's go ahead and select a point. So as you can see, now a square or a rectangle is formed. So you can go ahead and enter the value as 50 and 50. So now we have a square of 50 dimension. So now let's click on finish sketch so that we have to extrude it now. Now click on create, click on extrude. So now let's extrude it at a distance of 50. So now we have a cube of 50 dimension. Here is a bonus tip for you. At the bottom we have our timeline. So if you want to edit any point of your sketch, you can go back and edit your sketch. And say if you want to change your dimensions, your length or breadth. So let's go here and change it into 60. And let's change it to 90. And when you press on finish sketch, you can see that in your final three-dimensional model also, those dimensions have changed. So this is a very powerful feature of Fusion 360.
If you like the video, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit that bell icon. So that next time when we post a video, you will be notified. So I'll be seeing you in the next video. Goodbye.